rusty truck. Crazy dog.
Not right now. Bring your dog.
Okay. We're at it again. There goes a little old train motoring through. We was had our job picked out, and apparently the GPS ain't gonna show us where the job is here in town, since it says it's 100 and some miles to the job or something. So we're gonna have to go find the job. We'll just go out through here, that sawmill out here just a little ways. We'll go out here and get us a different load. Yeah, we will. I hauled a load into this sawmill last night.
Yeah, we did.
I didn't ask you, Doug. I'm telling
you. Yeah, what?
I hauled a load into this sawmill last night. Man, it had the hardest parking place in the world. Thank you, Heavy Alex, the mount maker, but and I wanted to make a video of it, and I didn't record it. I seen when I got done the record thing wasn't on, and that was terrible, because it was the awfulest parking place there was to get into. You can see it when I go out here and try to get me a load, but that happens when the duck ain't watching what we're doing. Yeah, you gotta keep your eyes on me, boy. I bet there's some fish in that creek you can catch, Duck. I ain't got time, Duck. I am driving a Freightliner LoneStar. Made by Mega Truck. INTER capital BM. Mega Truck, enter BM. And the engine sounds are made by Freddie Jermag. Making him a little video here of the truck. Just thought I'd fill you in on that. And over here we're going to the sawmill. There's the cops, Doug. I just thought I'd tell you.
Yeah, yeah, well.
Quit talking to people like that, Doug. They won't do nothing with the cops there. No, they won't. Now, I had to take that load in through here last night. Around all this stuff, didn't know where I was going. It was daylight, though. And we come around through here, and I kept going and going. I said, now where in the world am I going to park this thing? And kept going, nowhere to park. And kept going around this. Yeah, it was a mess. Went around this log truck, and I seen this little hole right here. Not hardly room to turn now. Where we had to park is to the right of us, right straight out the passenger side window inside the garage in that little hole there. So that's what we did with that load.
That's right.
Right inside them doors right there is where we had to park that thing. And pulled the truck in basically the same way, then had to find some way to turn the thing around in this little spot here. But I actually thought about canceling, but I actually got it in there. Yeah, I was about to give up on it for maybe, I don't know if I ever canceled one or not, but I was about to. It was a rough spot to get her lined up to go through that door. Now I'm in the duck's got wood, tall, gonna come out here and hook on to her and take her somewhere so somebody can erect some kind of structure. Here we go, Duff. I was wrong about this truck too. It's an international LoneStar. I don't know what I was thinking about, but correct myself there on that. That's the only chassis set up that'll work on it. Right now, they need to work on it some more. That's the only chassis setup you can get on it. First time I ever run a chassis setup with four steerable tires, but that's the one it'll work with. International LoneStar. Big old bronze color. We're gonna try to get her out of here now. You watch that old word up. You can't be asking the cops what they're doing out there, Doc. You better be glad they're busy talking. Yeah, right. They take you downtown and book you. They set you in the jailhouse, huh? Hey, Doug. Story time. I met an old friend of mine the other night in the bar, and he got drunk and he wanted to fight. Yeah, he jumped up and challenged every man in the room. And just about the time he got the words out, old boy jumped up and shut his mouth. And he used his head for a mop, his butt for a broom. Yeah, that's what he needed. That's what he needed. You know, I've got this big old brother-in-law, and me and him just don't never get along, Doug. Because he wants to make sure I'm treating his sister right. He got drunk one night and started beating me up. I went out and got a lug wrench out of my truck. I laid him out as cold as a block of ice. Now when he comes to see me, he comes around with his hat in his hand. Yeah, I done that. Not only that stuff, Duck, a lot more stuff went on. A whole bunch of stuff. Well, one night my girlfriend slapped me in the face and I said, darling, that was your first mistake. Then she went wild and her eyes turned red. She started breaking everything in the house and screaming out loud and kicking me and cussing me out. I gave her a little adjustment right there on the top of the head. She called the cops to take me in, and I said, "You're never gonna do it, friends." And they said, "Oh yes, we will." Now, a stick to the head, some kicks to the chin, and several bites from their canine friend. And I couldn't wait to get in that jail.
You went to jail?
Yeah, I went to jail. Well, that's the story, Doug. But, yeah, you can give them a little attitude adjustment, but you might wind up in jail. That was Hank Williams Jr.'s lyrics to Attitude Adjustment. And I know a lot of people is waiting in line needing one of those. Most folks I see could use one.
Is that right?
Yeah, Doug, you on top of the list. You smack who around?
I smack who around?
I needed another feather, Doug. Liking the sound on this truck pretty good. If anybody thinks driving the way I'm driving here is easy, give it a try. Get about 10 buttons you have to mash and all that kind of stuff and try to drive like this. Gets kind of confusing. Watching around corners you can't see around, all that kind of stuff. I only do that so you don't have to spend the whole video looking at a dashboard. But I guess I could stand there about 50% of the time, 50% of the time out of there, but it's not easy to drive like that. Too much stuff to do, too many adjustments and turning and trying to see where you're going and hoping there ain't nothing parked and all that kind of stuff.
That's right. You ask, what did you do?
I am in the truck, Duck. Here I am, see?
Yeah.
Well, I see the gauges don't work on this. Yet, they're going to work on it more, I think. The digital display over there does work. The time, the gear, how many gallons of gas you got left, all that kind of stuff. The mirrors on the hood, I like those. The one on the left works good all the time. The one on the right freezes every once in a while. See, I'm driving right here right now. I do that in real life. Scares my wife to death. She screams and hollers. And I just can't understand why, because that shoulder over there. And there's nothing to hurt you. But when the paint people paint that line to get back on the road, if I ain't back on the road by then, she just panics on me. Got all kinds of room over there. I don't know why she panics. I don't know. I'm just a bad driver. But I drive just like that on the real road, right beside that 50 mile an hour over on the shoulder. When I merge, I merge. I've seen people stop. Them old granny ladies, they pull up to that merging thing. If anybody's coming, they'll stop dead still. There'll be traffic backed up for miles. Now, which one you think's the most dangerous? Just saying, you know.
Yeah, that's right. I'm going to ride with you, Russian.
Sound like you in a bucket of water, Duck.
No, I'm not. That was trying,
what? What for?
A bucket full of fish.
You want a bucket of water full of fish?
Yeah, I want a box of fish. I got my box of fish.
You're not been bumming for fish 2 or 3 weeks.
And I got two of them about myself.
Well, looks like it might be clouding up a bird up. Tell everybody what your job is, Doug.
Yeah, my job is to shoot the dog.
Boy, ain't he got a good job? People just sit and talk. That's all he does.
That's right.
Oh, yeah, and he spies on me. He got a spy number anyway. What was your number, Doug?
0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0
The truck does drive like a peach. drive, that front end looked like a monster face. Reminded me of that truck on that killer truck movie. Whatever it's called, the truck that had the green mask on my face. Might have been the same kind. Don't remember. When I first put this truck together, I put a low top on the low top sleeper on it. I didn't like it at all with the low top sleeper. It made it look too short and too wide. The high top helped it a lot. But I'm not drunk driving here. Now I see this man on his motorcycle, and I ride motorcycles. I'm gonna try my best to get out that old boy's way. You don't mess with them baggers. Or you might accidentally run over one. Don't want to do that. The duck, he rides a 50cc job. He says he keeps up with me on my 1700 Roadstar, but I don't believe it. I might have told you fellas once about drafting a motorcycle. I don't know if I did or not, but my son's riding a 750 one time. And I don't know if it's running right or not. In some hills, it wouldn't top 65 mile an hour. I told him to, just fooling around one day, I said, get him behind me there. Straight in behind me, I said. Pretty close. I cranked mine up to 65, and he was there, 70, back there grinning, 75, he was grinning. 80, he's still smiling. Up to about 85, he's still right there, and I pulled over to the right, and he said he thought the motor's going to blow up on him when I moved out in front of him. You can draft on a motorcycle, even. What do you think about that? Who would have thought it? Knocked the wind off of it and thing running like a race car. I bet that's what you do with that little 50cc. Get in by mine. I just dragged you. Where are we going? Well, that's a big word for you, Duck. Tremendous.
Yeah.
You got a good vocabulary, Duck. My name's not Jack, told you that. Give you attitude adjustment.
Told you what? Double O Four.
What's your name, 004? Yeah, you have set backwards like James Bond, don't you? Bond. James. That ain't right.
Duck.
That sounds better. A duck that's crazy. See that town name I just crossed into, Alex? M-A-J, Promap, is this one of the new towns you built? I'm discovering a lot of towns for a man that's drove around as much as I have. I think new towns springing up everywhere,
though.
What do you know about it? Not
much.
I see her delivery point.
Gotcha.
Another job well done.
Well, maybe it's moving okay and maybe not.
Well, that's right too. It could have been, could not have been. Like to run that little loader there, I'd get in that loader and just shove this pile of wood over where it needs to be. Amanda Duck of Sporting Wood gonna take her in here and park it. And all that load of steel, maybe. I'd get a big load of coal. You fellas would haul, put some coal in the game. I was talking to these fellas around here the other day and asked a fella, and they said they usually haul around 60 tons. Said they could get permits to haul. I think he said like up to 100 or 120 tons get special permits, but they usually haul around 60, 70 tons. That's a pretty good load of coal on them Peterbilts and stuff running wide open up and down the road, and they'll outrun a car with that on them too. Them things, some strong engines. Never seen nothing run like these new trucks, these new Peterbilts and stuff out there on the road. They're the old ones, you get them. You get going down the road with your car and you're doing 75 and think you're flying up a hill, and here come a big old Peterbilt pass and you're loaded. Never seen nothing like it. Looks like we did good, Mr. Doug.
Yeah, we did.
Folks, she's a pretty nice looking truck. Very nice looking truck. Had a nice paint job. I started painting blue, and I didn't like the blue too much. I like that bronze color. I put that bottom bar on it, light bar. It don't exactly fit right. It comes out a little too far. Got that one light sticking out there about the wheel. That was just a little too much on the light bar. But on the front, it's got a license plate says Freddy over here on this side. Yeah, it's pretty cool. There you go.
Thanks for watching, everybody. I'm a chance. Grab your gun. Give me a sword. Grab your gun.
Rusty Truck, Crazy Duck. Thank y'all for watching. Subscribe.